Recently, it was announced that NASA is planning to send a crewed mission back to the Moon and to Mars. Obviously, huge technological challenges will need to be overcome before these missions can be successfully accomplished. NASA researchers realize that trips like these will require building the appropriate type of spacecraft, having flawless life support systems, and will need the right tools to perform work once we arrive on these distant worlds. But a major concern that often gets overlooked by the general public is what types of food will be eaten by our astronauts on these long missions. Fortunately, previous missions to low Earth orbit in the space shuttle and longer missions aboard the International Space Station have helped NASA better understand how food and the astronaut interact. But not much is known about how food will fare on these long missions. The primary goal of the food systems in these long missions will be to provide a palatable, nutritious, and safe food for our explorers while also taking up as little room as possible. Food is vital for survival here on Earth, but is even more important in some respects in space. Its preparation, quantity, and quality are critical and can affect astronauts on a physiological level. One of the most crucial problems on long missions is bone loss. Typically, astronauts lose 1 to 2% of bone mass each month that they are in space, especially in the lower halves of their bodies. In the weightless environment of space, there is almost no stress on the skeletal system. Bones are no longer providing support to walk and are not being used to maintain body posture. This lack of stress on the bones may be a key factor in an astronaut's progressive bone loss in space. Other problems like fluid shift and space motion sickness must be taken into account when providing food to the astronaut crews. Meals must be chosen that can help slow many of the problems faced by astronauts. Another major concern for NASA food scientists is the stability of food that is packaged for these missions. It's vital that the food remain edible for years at a time, staying safe and stable aboard the spacecraft. This is perhaps one of the most important factors of the planned long-duration missions. If the food spoils, there are no options currently available to astronauts for nourishment. With missions to Mars requiring at least 3 years to complete, stored food must remain shelf-stable for that time, preferably longer. In the short term, food systems that are currently being used aboard the shuttle and space station are suitable for transit to another world. But once astronauts arrive, other alternatives need to be considered. With these thoughts in mind, researchers at NASA are developing new ways to help crews eat well in space. In addition to storing food aboard the spacecraft, many at NASA believe that growing food in space or on planetary surfaces will need to be perfected to help feed astronauts on these long missions.